Hello mga kananay, it's me again, Nanay Jane, and welcome back to our YouTube channel. If you are new to this channel, please consider subscribing and hit the notification bell so that you will be updated whenever we have new uploads about ESL teaching, work from home, and motherhood. So today is a very special day because this is the very first episode of Nanay Jane Meets. If you noticed, I have been uploading videos about ESL companies, but I know that you deserve more and you need more than that. Because I'm only giving you information based on my research, but I want to give you first-hand information. That's why I decided to invite ESL teachers from every company that I want to share to you. And for today, we are very honored to have an EGOX teacher. So please welcome Teacher Kimmy.
Okay, hi Nanay Jane. Thank you for having me sa ganitong platform mo, and also I'm honored na kinontak mo ko for this one. Okay, so I'd like to introduce myself. I'm the person sa Teach Kimmy. Tapos basically, I was a IT engineer before. So working for over 10 years sa IT. Tapos, tinry ko mag-switch to ESL kasi I started last year. So, natutuwa kasi ako makipag-usap sa mga tao. And then, also, when I was in Japan, na while I was working there din, on Saturdays and Sundays, nag-volunteer ako to teach young Japanese children English. So, dahil doon sa mga exposure na yon, I decided to, why not try ESL? So, now I'm working as a part-time ESL teacher din sa EGOX.
Wow, nakakahanga naman yung teach. Parang ang laking adjustment for you from being an IT yes. engineer to an ESL teacher. Upon meeting you, I think nag-e-enjoy ka naman as an ESL teacher din.
Oo, sobrang saya. Dami mong nami-meet na iba't ibang klaseng tao, and you can also learn a lot from them.
Right, exactly.
Yes.
Can you tell us, Teacher Kimmy, about EGOX? Because unlike other ESL companies, na kapag sinerch mo sa YouTube, ang dami nang lalabas na vlogs, and kapag sinerch mo sa Google, ang dami na ring information about this company. Pero actually, itong EGOX, I just heard it from one of my ESL teacher na friend, ESL friend din. And sabi ko, parang na-curious ako sa company na to, pero I can't find a lot of information about this. So please tell us about this company.
Ah, yes. Ako din, when I started looking for a job, online job as an ESL teacher, nahirapan din ako maghanap ng information about this company. So, pero mas marami siyang information when you try to search in Japanese. So, yun yung ginawa ko for this one. And then, nakita ko may isang page lang sila na nandun lahat ng requirements for the applicants. So I tried it there. So this company pala is from Japan. It's basically based in Osaka, Japan. So they were already there since 2000. So yun, they are also hiring a lot of people all around the globe. That also includes Filipinos. Medyo confusing yung nandun sa website nila, but yes, they accept Filipinos, and nakita ko din marami ng Filipinos na nandito sa company na ito. And most of the people that I have talked with, they are all Japanese. Tapos yung nag-interview din sa akin are also Japanese. So basically, puro Hapon yung nagmamanage ng company na ito.
I see. So it's Japanese-based ESL company. And yes. Which means, ang students ba dito, Teacher Kimmy, ay Japanese students din? Lahat sila Japanese?
Based sa mga natry ko, the students that enrolled in my classes, they were Japanese, but three of them were working in Japan, but they are Chinese students.
Oh.
So, but they are at the age of 40 plus, so already working in Japan, and they also know Japanese, and they are trying to learn English at the same time.
Oh, I see. But meron din ba dito na kids and adults?
Ah, yes. May mga bata dito. Based on my experience, 3 years old yung youngest na try ko. It was challenging, yes. Kasi based, mostly matatanda yung mga kausap ko. And then the oldest one was around 75 years old. In this platform, pwede kang mag-set ng, pwede ako magturo ng kids. Kasi may option sila. Parang may radio button. So, isi-select or i-unselect mo lang yun siya. But basically, ang default sa profile mo, if you know how to speak basic Japanese, they will set it as kids okay. Yes. Otherwise, sa adults ka, lalabas na search result.
Now, how about Teacher Kimi? I know ito yung isa sa pinaka laging tinatanong ng mga ESL teacher. How much ba basically yung kaya nating ma-earn dito sa EGOKS?
Ah, yes. You will start 150 yen pag ano, meron kang number of lessons at the start. So 150 yen for 25-minute class. Tapos after that, after maybe 10 lessons, as far as I can remember, mga ganon, magle-level up siya. Magiging 160 yen per 25 minutes. Then may kailangan kang i-reach na mga requirements. For example, dapat less than 1% of the total class yung kinansel mo. So, kasi 'di ba may mga issues na mangyayari like wala tayong internet. So, may times na masakit yung ulo natin or the teacher is not really feeling good. So, ika-cancel yung classes. So, dapat yung cancellation rate would be less than 1%. Tapos feedback ng students, i-consider din yan. So, may mga step. Tapos yung maximum would be 600 yen per 25 minutes.
Oh, I see. And speaking of cancellation, Teacher Kimi, meron ba mga penalties din dito kay Agox?
Ah, yes, may penalty. As far as I can remember, pwede kang, si teacher, pwedeng mag-cancel 24 hours before sa student. So walang cancellation doon, but after that may minus na. Doon may penalty na sa side ng teacher.
Dito ba kay Agox is it's like private tutorial or
Yes. Yes
Oh.
po. Ah, tapang po Nanay Jane, para kasi yung contract ng namin dito sa EGOKS is freelance teacher. So, you are okay within 10 hours. In a week, maglagay ka dun sa calendar mo. Open ka ng slot at least 10 hours per week. Pagkatapos niyan, so students will book you. So maghihintay ka ng mga bookings from students. And then pwede ka din mag-set ng, for example, minimum of 12 hours or 6 hours before sa na-schedule mo, pwede ka pang i-book ni student. Maraming freedom si teacher kung paano
Oo.
niya i-handle yung schedule niya or i-communicate yung students niya through Skype din pala yung ano dito,
Yung
yung
classes.
lessons.
Yeah, parang free yung teacher na laruin yung schedule niya and free
Yes.
din siya na makipag-communicate sa students kung kailan pwede kayong magklase.
Yes, most of the time, may mga regular students na din akong nagather since last year. So, marami-rami na rin. And then, they would ask me nga, na minsan hindi pa ako nakalagay or nakaplot ng schedule sa calendar. Tapos natapos na yung class namin and they would just message me na, are you available next week? I haven't seen your schedule. So please let me know if you already open. So magre-reply na lang din ako sa mga students ko pag open na yung schedule.
Are lesson materials provided by the company?
Ah, of course, available siya. Meron siyang basic and then meron din for business. And then meron din for kids. Tapos when the students, they would like you to have a free talk or something. So that's one example ng types of lessons. I think meron din yan sa ibang ESL class, ESL companies. Ang mangyayari is depende na sa teacher or sa student kung ano yung pag-uusapan nila. So that time, may freedom si teacher kung ano yung gagawin niya during that free talk na class request.
I see. But other than that, for other lessons na ibinok ni student, materials are already provided.
Opo, opo.
Oh, kailangan din ba dito ng mga props or other materials?
Ay, hindi po. Wala po kaming materials na kailangan. But si teacher, kung for example, maraming kids na nagbubuk sa kanya, yes, of course, you have the freedom to add additional. Minsan nga lang, as far as I can remember, may isa kong student na gustong-gusto niyang mag-origami kami lagi, yung mga paper folding. So, yun yung ginagawa namin lagi sa class. Tapos, ini-integrate ko na lang yung English.
Wow, that's fun. Listen natin, para
yes.
Nakikipaglaro lang tayo sa bata.
Mm-mm.
That's nice. Okay, so ngayon, Teacher Kimmy, another important question na gustong malaman ng viewers natin, of course, is ano ba yung basic requirements para sa mga gustong mag-apply dito kay EGOX?
Ah, yes. So, yung marami na din akong natanggap na questions based kung ano yung mga requirements dito. Meron lang silang isang website. Sabi dito sa website is at least excellent English speaker of the second language, tapos clear yung accent and pronunciation, tapos friendly, encouraging, and patient. And for the equipments, hindi naman nila ni-require kung ano yung speed. Sinabi lang dito is high speed internet, tapos pwedeng yung computer mo or your laptop merong webcam, tapos pwedeng gamitin yung Skype.
Kailangan din ba teach ng mga teaching certificates or license, ganyan?
Wala pong nakalagay dito sa requirements nila. Ako din po, wala po din akong TEFL or TESOL. So, I think yung hinahanap nila is yung clear yung English, tapos may personality, may good personality na magturo sa mga students. I think on their side, that's enough.
Right, yung capability and willingness ng teacher na magturo ng students. Yan.
Yes po.
So, paano naman teach ngayon ang pag-a-apply? So, how to apply? Can you just give us an idea kung ano yung pinagdaanan mo sa application mo?
Ah, yes. Okay, on the same website, may button silang nakalagay na application form. So, nag-submit lang ako ng application through that. Tapos, naghintay ako ng response sa kanila. Yung timing last year, 2020, medyo may influx of applicants. So, naghintay ako ng around 2 months, saka pa nila ako na-replyan. Tapos, after that, all the communication are done through email. So, expect kayo na may mga 1 to 3 emails kayong matatanggap every after may sinend kayong update sa kanila. So, yung first process was parang interview, less than 30 minutes na interview about your self-introduction. Tapos, tinanong nila yung reasons why gusto mo mag-apply sa EGOX. Tapos, after that, my second interview, which is yung my demo. Pero, minor lang yon, mga 10 minutes siguro yung maximum sa demo. Yung nangyari sa demo, basahin lang yung nandun sa email nila. Kasi, para siyang gagamitin niyo yung mga lesson materials na actually nandun na din sa EGOX na platform. So, after that, maghihintay kayo kung pasado o hindi. And then, if you passed, you will update your profile sa EGOX. Then, after updating your profile, maghintay kayo ng update din sa kanila na active na yung profile mo. But also, after that, make sure din to make a PayPal account kasi yung salary will be shared through PayPal.
Habang nakikinig ako sa Teacher Kimmy, ang application process dito kay EGOX hindi ganun kahirap compared sa other ESL companies, no? But ang kailangan, I think, is patience. Kasi lalo
yes.
kapag madaming applicants.
Yes.
Ayan, so it will really take time for them to send you an email or an update
opo.
About your application.
Opo.
Okay, so wow, I think natanong ko na Teacher Kimmy lahat ng essential question or information na kailangan ng mga ESL applicants. But for your, I think this would be the final part. Yan. So ano po ang mensahe ninyo para or tips para sa mga aspiring EGOX teacher and newbies also?
Yes. Aspiring EGOX teachers and newbies, yes. Number one tip is always be on time. Alam natin na 1 hour advance yung oras ni Japan sa Philippines. So, siguro may times na mako-confuse tayo. So, when you have your demo schedule or an interview schedule, make sure kung ano yung nakasulat dun sa email. Kasi minsan, yung nakalagay sa kanila is, for example, 1 o'clock JST. So that would mean 12 noon Philippine time. Okay? So yun yung number one tip. Tapos yung second tip ko is always smile. Kasi mas maganda yan. Makabuild kayo ng rapport sa interviewer nyo and also your students. Tapos, number three, sa mga new teachers sa EGOX, always ask for feedback sa students nyo. Kasi in EGOX, you are also building your own profile. Yung sa profile nyo, may comments na nakikita yung other students or prospect students. So, after your class, it's best to ask them na pwede ba silang maglagay ng comment for you para malaman mo din kung which parts are kailangan i-improve or which parts are really good sa kanila. So, yun lang po. Salamat po, Nanay Jane.
Thank you so much, Teacher Kimmy, for accepting my invitation. And don't forget to subscribe to her YouTube channel and support her also.
So, medyo maliit pa lang po yung ano ko, yung videos dun sa YouTube channel ko. But I'm trying to build up of a lot of videos related to maybe possible, aside from ESL, pwedeng gagawa ko ng mga tools like Gmail, how to use or how to use a Gmail account, how to send emails. Those something that pwedeng gamitin din for online classes. So thank you everyone and always smile when you are teaching.
Okay, that's it mga kananay. Again, Teacher Kimmy, thank you so much for accepting my invitation. And you know you are a very good person. So I know that your channel will be more blessed as well. So mga kananay, please don't forget to subscribe to her YouTube channel. And if you have further questions about EGOX, you may reach her through her YouTube channel and through her Facebook page, Teach Kimmy. So, God bless you mga kananay and see you in our next episode. Bye!